I purchased the DeWalt saw about 18 months ago, and Evolution sent me the Rage 2 saw about 6 months ago. I came up with a comparison, which I think is unique and I think is fair. How well do these two saws perform the single task that I need them to do for my work, and that is to cut thick aluminum stock like this, which is 1 by 6 inch. The DeWalt saw does a far better job cutting this sort of material than the Rage 2 saw does. Your purposes may be different, and maybe the Rage 2 saw would be more appropriate for you. Both saws do a great job cutting thin material like quarter inch aluminum and steel din rail. You can actually feed the saw quicker than I am here. I wasn't sure how it would handle the din rail on edge like this. The cuts are pretty burr free. A little light filing is all that's needed, and it's certainly a cleaner cut than an abrasive chop saw gives. Where these saws really excel is making quick square cuts into material like this aluminum angle. The cut is clean and nearly burr free. The Evolution saw lets thin material like this steel stock be clamped without any support. The DeWalt saw needs some backing material for thin stock. See the angle of the clamp against the fence? First, I want to look at the clamp and fence of the Evolution saw, and as the clamp is tightened, it actually lifts itself and the material off of the bed. And this might not be a big deal, you just have to be aware of it because it can affect the squareness. Because the faces of the clamp and fence are parallel on the Evolution saw, a V-groove plate is installed onto the clamp, which pushes the round stock into the fence, holds it in position. The DeWalt design that has an angled face on the clamp and doesn't require any additional hardware to hold round stock. This is a 2.5 inch or about 64 millimeter piece of 1215 steel. It takes about a minute to cut on the DeWalt saw, and the really nice thing about these saws is once the piece is off, it's cold, and unlike abrasive blades, there is no dust and sparks. If cutting long material, just support it at the end. The Evolution saw, at least the blade it comes with, has a real problem of chip buildup on the teeth. And now compare that to the DeWalt saw and the blade it comes with, which has no trouble cutting through even thicker material. The Evolution Rage 2 blade, barely a quarter into the material, is already showing chips packed onto the teeth. The backward facing lobes might be a way of limiting the feed rate into the material, but the blade has half the number of teeth, so maximum feed rate is also half. Compare that to the DeWalt blade, which is a much more wicked looking blade, more teeth, sharper teeth, and much more room for chip evacuation. This is the Evolution Rage 2 blade included with the Rage 2 saw. And this is the DeWalt blade included with the DeWalt MultiCutter. Because of the additional teeth, there's more chips, but the chips are also longer, and there is no problem with chip packing. To minimize the number of teeth engaged with the stock, this is the recommended orientation. Because of the blade guard design, a lot of the chips on the Rage 2 saw are cared around the guard and ejected out the front. The DeWalt saw is much more successful throwing the chips out the back. This is a quick and dirty comparison between the horizontal and vertical orientation of the stock and its effect on cutting speed. The downward pressure that I apply is mainly dependent upon the sound and the feel of the saw, and anyone who has operated a saw like this will understand. And that is to say that I'm trying to be consistent with my use of the saw instead of consistent with the exact pressure that I'm applying. So again, this comparison is completely unscientific. But I think it's pretty fair to say that the vertical orientation, if you can do it, will result in a faster cut. Okay, so after checking to make certain all the teeth are cleared of packed aluminum chips, I'm going to make the same cut that just took about 20 seconds on the DeWalt saw using the Rage 2 saw. Because of the design of the Rage 2 blade with half of the lobes having teeth and the other half not, we might expect the Rage 2 saw to take roughly twice as long as the DeWalt saw. The saw is shuttering quite a bit now, and there's few chips being thrown out the front of the saw, so I'm pretty sure that all the teeth are packed with aluminum now.
and that was the circuit breaker tripping. The Rage 2 saw with the blade it comes with is unusable for thicker aluminum stock. I tried blade wax, I tried WD-40, none of it helps. Eventually the teeth are packed with aluminum and it no longer cuts. The DeWalt saw is $435. The Evolution Rage 2 saw is $220. And a new blade to make it useful with aluminum is $107. And the Evolution EvoSaw 380, which seems to address some of the problems with the Rage 2 saw, is $379. By the time the cost of the blade is added to the Rage 2 purchase price, close to the cost of the EvoSaw 380, and that saw has the nicest base of the three saws on the summary page. If you're not cutting aluminum, then the Rage 2 saw may be a good purchase. If you do get a chop saw, consider budgeting for a bandsaw, because small cuts like these are not going to be possible to do safely on a chop saw.